Namaste children, how are you all? I hope you are fine. And in the last class we have discussed some of the applications of some of the end terms of mathematical progression in solving some of the sums. Now we will discuss a few more problems from exercise number 5.3. That is question number 8. Find the sum of first 51 terms of an AB. How many terms you have to find? What we need to find? We have to find sum means addition of how many terms? 51 terms of an AB whose second and third terms are 14 and 18 respectively. Second term is given 14 and third term is given 18. So what is given here? Two terms are given, that is second term and third term are given, and number of terms is given, that is 51 terms. What we need to find? Sum of n terms of an arithmetic progression. So how do we find sum of n terms of arithmetic progression? Here we have two formulas are there. That is Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That is this formula we use when we know the common difference, number of terms and first term. But here we know number of terms n we know, but we don't know the first term and we don't know the common difference which we need to find first. The other formula is there, Sn is equals to n by 2 into a plus n. That is when we know the first term and last term. Here both the terms are not known to us. That is first term is not known to us and last term also it is not known to us. Then how to find the sum of first 51 terms with the given data? So what are given? So first write given data. So what are given here in this? Here given it is n is equals to 51, n is equals to 51, and what are given? Second term is given a2, a2 is equals to what? 14, a2 is equals to 14, and a3 is equals to it is 18, a3 is equals to 18. So what we need to find here, we have to find sum of first 51 term, that is s51 is equals to what? This we need to find. So given data it is number of terms, that is 51, a2 that is second term is equals to 14, and a3 is equals to it is 18. Now so to find s15, what is the formula? Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So d is not known to us. What is the formula for d? D is equals to, that is the difference, common difference is equals to the difference of any two consecutive terms of the arithmetic progression. Consecutive terms means successive terms. Now if you observe here, a2 and a3 both are not successive terms are there. So can you find from these two, that is third term and second term, can you find the common difference? Yes. Therefore d is equals to a3 minus a2, which is equals to what? a3 is equals to 18 minus 14, that is equals to 4. So now d is equals to what? 4. Can we find now a, that is the first term, can we find? We know, that is second term we know. Now, but a2 is equals to, that is a plus d, that is first term plus common difference. a2 is equals to how much? It is 14, that is equals to a we need to find, plus d is equals to common difference, it is what? 4. Then transpose plus 4 to left hand side, we get plus 4 will become minus 4, that is equals to a. 14 minus 4 is equals to 10, 10 is equals to a. So now what is the first term here? It is a is equals to 10, second term it is 14, third term it is 18, common difference it is 4. Now what we need to find? Sum of 51 terms of the given arithmetic progression. So what is the formula to find sum of n terms? Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So write the formula, correct formula we need to write, and then substitute the values which are given or which we found, which are required to substitute. So here n is equals to what? 51 terms. Therefore it is s51 is equals to n is equals to what it is? 51. 51 by 2, that is 2 into a is equals to how much we got? 10 plus n minus 1, n is equals to 51 minus 1 into d is equals to what it is? Common difference what we got here is 4. Substitute this 4 in the place of d. Now 51 by 2. Simplify inside. 2 into 10 it is 20 plus 51 minus 1 it is 50. 50 into 4 which is equals to 51 divided by 2 into 20 plus 50 into 4. 5 4s are 20 and keep 0, 200 we get. That is equals to 51 by 2 into 20 plus 200 is 220. Now simplify this. 51 by 2 into 220. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2 and 2 0s are 0, which is equals to 51 into 110. That is equals to, yes, 51 is equals to 51 into 110. So we know the 11th table, multiply. 11 1s are 11, 1 is there. 11 5s are 55. 55 plus 1 it is 56. And keep this 0. So how much you get? How much you get? 5610. So like this, we'll find the sum of 50 terms, 51 terms of the given arithmetic progression. So here, see, it is given. Consecutive terms are given. A2 and A3 are given. That is 14 and 18. A 14 is the second term and 18 is the third term. Number of terms are given. So we are using this formula. So to find sum of n terms, we use this formula. So to use this formula, what should be known to us? N should be known, A should be known, and D should be known. N is given in the question 51. D is not, we don't know, and A also we don't know. So before finding sum of 51 terms, we need to find first term and the common difference. So common difference, as these two given terms are consecutive terms, their difference will give us what common difference be. Then when you substitute in that second term, which is equals to a plus b, in this when you substitute, you will get a value, that is first term as 10. Then substitute in the formula and simplify, will get sum of 51 terms is equals to 5610. Like this. Now instead of giving second and third, that is consecutive terms, for example, second term and fifth term are given. Second term and fifth term are given. How to solve this? How to solve this kind of sums? When fifth term and second term are given, you need to find from that common difference. Just roughly I'll explain. You may need to sum in the examination. So if it is given second term as second term is equals to A2 is equals to 14 and A5 is equals to what it is? 10. 10 plus 4 into 4 it is 16. It is just I am taking the values. 26. 26. You see here, first term is 10, then 14, 18, add 4, you'll get 22, then add 4, you get 26. Then how to find the sum of 51 terms? So I'll tell you how to apply this concept in the previous class. Previous exercise. So A2 is equals to A plus B, that is equals to 14. A5 is equals to what? A plus 4D, that is equals to 26. Solve these two equations. Solve these two linear equations. You got two linear equations. Solve these two equations. Subtract second equation from the first equation. We get this as a minus, and this is also minus. This is also minus. Plus A, minus A are cancelled. Then what we have? Plus D, minus 4D. Minus 4D plus D is equals to minus 3D. That is equals to 14 minus 26. Again, the two integers, one negative, one positive. So subtract the numbers. 26 minus 14 is 12, and keep the negative sign, it is minus 12. Then D is equals to minus 1 by minus 3. Minus and minus gets cancelled. 3 ones are 3 fours. So we got how much has D? D we got it is 4. What we got here also? 4. So this is when the consecutive terms are not given, different terms are given. Like this, we will solve this kind of sums. We got D is equals to 4. Substitute D is equals to 4 in either this equation or this equation. We will get A value. When apply this formula, we can find this. So this is when we get the when the non-consecutive terms are given. Non-consecutive terms are given, we follow this method. When consecutive terms are given, we follow this method. Is it clear to you? Yes. Now, next ninth question. If the sum of first 7 terms of an AB is 49 and that of 17 terms is 289, find the sum of first n terms. So what it is? If the sum of first 7 terms of an AB is 49, 7 terms and 49, 7 and 49. Next, 17 terms, 289. Find the sum of first n terms. What might be the n term? Can anybody guess? Yes, it is n square. How can you say? If you observe this, 7 square is 49. 17 square is 289. Means n square. N sum of n terms will be square of n, that is n square. We will solve how to find here. So what are given here in this question? Sum of 7 terms are given, that is S7 is equals to 49. S7 is equals to 49 and S17 is equals to 289. It is given. And what we need to find? Sn is equals to how much? So these two things are given in the question. That is, sum of first 7 terms is equals to 49. Sum of first 17 terms is equals to 289. Then find sum of first n terms. It is also, they may ask this question in the exam, in the, what it is, objective questions also. If the sum of first 7 terms of an AB is 49 and that of 17 terms is 289, find the sum of first n terms. The sum of first n terms is dash. The answer will be n square. If they ask you, the sum of first 16 terms is 16 square, that is 256. Sum of 10 terms is 10 square, it is 100. In the objectives also, this question will be asked. One of the important sum, it is right. So now, 17, S7 is equals to 49 and S17 is equals to 289. So from this, we'll get one linear equation, and from this, we'll get one linear equation. So from this, you solve this. From here, that is S7 is equals to, what is the form of S? Sum of n terms, Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That is, S7 is equals to 7 by 2 into 2a plus n is equals to 7 minus 1 into d. Here we don't know the first term and we don't know the common difference. Anything, we know only sum of 7 terms and sum of 17 terms. Other than this, we don't know anything. So first find a and first find d. Why? To find sum of any terms, what is the formula? That is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So what should be known? N should be known, a should be known and d should be known. We don't know. So first we need to find a and d. That is again by using this concept. Which one it is? Using by solving the linear equations. So for S7, S7 is equals to how much it is? 49. Substitute. 49 is equals to 7 by 2 into 2a plus 7 minus 1 it is 6b. That is equals to, now 49 is equals to 7 by 2, 2a plus 6b. Here 2 and here 6 means it is 2 into 3. 6 means 2 into 3. Can you take 2 common? Yes, then take 2 common into 2, then a plus 3b. That is 2 ones are cancelled. Now 49 is equals to 7 into a plus 3b. Transpose 7 to this left hand side. As it is multiplying, when we transpose to this side, it will divide. That is equals to 49. That is equals to 49 by 7. 49 by 7 is equals to a plus 3b. 7 ones are 7, 7 is there. Therefore, a plus 3d is equals to 7. Equation 1. This is equation 1. Similarly, find from this one equation S17. S17 is equals to, yes, 17 is equals to 17 by 2 formula. 17 by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. N is equals to 17 minus 1 into d. That is equals to, S17 is how much is given? 289 that is equals to 17 by 2 into 2a plus 17 minus 1 it is 16. 16 into d it is 16d that is equals to 289 is equals to 17 by 2 into again 2a and 16d. 16 means 2 into 8. Take 2 common. Then we get a plus 8d. So 212 cancel, get 12. Transpose 17 to this side. 289 by 17 that is equals to a plus 8d. 17 ones are 70. 17 ones are 70. 28 minus 17 is 11 and bring 9. 119. 17 sevens are 119. Or 17 seventeens are 289. Now a plus 8d is equals to 17. So now this is equation number 2. Solve these two equations. Solve the equations. A plus, that is a plus 3d is equals to 7 and a plus 8d is equals to 7. By solving these two equations, a and a will be cancelled. You can find the d value and substitute the d value in any one of these equations. We get a value. Then we can find the sum of n terms of the given arithmetic progression. Now, see the first equation, a plus 3d is equal to 7. Second equation, a plus 8 is equal to 17. These are two linear equations into variables. Now, subtract 1 from 2, or it is 2 minus 1, equation 2 minus equation 1. That is, a plus 8d is equal to 17, a plus 3d that is equal to 7. So where we are subtracting, the signs will change as this plus a, then it will become minus a. It is minus, this is also minus. Plus a, minus a, both are cancelled, you get 0. Plus 8d, minus 3d, subtract coefficients. 8 minus 3d is 5. 5d, that is equals to 17 minus 7. 17 minus 7 is equals to 10. Now d is equals to 10 by 5. Transpose 5. As it is 5 into d, it is multiplied, then it divides. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. Therefore, d is equals to how much? 2. Next, find a by substituting d is equals to 2, either in equation 1 or in equation 2. So now, substitute d is equals to, substitute d is equals to 2 in equation 1. So what is equation 1? It is a plus 3d. That is a plus 3d means 3 into d is equals to 2. That is equals to 7. A plus 3 into 2, it is 6, is equals to 7. Transpose 6 to the side. A is equals to 7 minus 6. That is a is equals to 1. So first term is equals to what? 1. Now we know d and we know a. What finally we wanted to find? Sum of first n terms, that is S n is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That is equals to n, we don't know, hence it is n by 2, n will take as n. 2a, a is equals to what? 1, substitute a as 1, 2 into 1 plus n minus 1, again we don't know n, write n minus 1 into d is equals to what it is? 2. In the place of d, write 2. Then simplify this. N by 2 into 2 into 1, 2 plus n into 2, it is 2n. Minus into plus, it is minus. 1 into 2, it is 2. Minus 2. Then plus 2, minus 2 are cancelled. You get 0. Now, n by 2 into 2n. So 2 ones are cancelled, that is n into n, it is n square. Therefore, Sn is equals to n square. That is sum of first n terms of the given arithmetic progression is n square. As I told you in the beginning, that is 7 square is 49, 17 square is 289. So definitely, in order to find sum of n terms, we get it's a square, that is n square. So this question they may ask in objectives also, as I discussed here. So now, so what is given here is sum of sum of first 7 terms is given, and sum of first 17 terms is given, and they asked you to find first n terms. So sum of 7 terms is equals to 49, sum of 17 terms is equals to 289. So we need to find Sn is equals to what? So from 7, sum of 7 terms, that is from 49, we get one linear equation, that is a plus bd is equals to 7. And then from second sum, that is sum of 17 terms, which is equals to 289, we get the second linear equation as a plus ad is equals to 17. Solve these two linear equations. So by using elimination method, we have linear equations, different methods are there solving these linear equations. So by subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we will get d as 2. Then substitute that d in equation 1 or equation 2 to get a. After finding a and d, write the formula of sum of n terms and substitute the values in the place of a and d as 1 and 2 respectively. Then we simplify, we get n square. Like this, we will find the sum of first n terms of the given arithmetic progression. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now we will discuss one more sum, 10th sum. Show that a1, a2, a3 and so on, n and so on form array P. So what we have to find? We have to find the terms a1, a2, a3, and we need to check whether this form, this series of numbers will form an arithmetic progression or not. Where an is given, an is defined as below, an is equal to 3 plus 4n, which is the first sum, and second sum is also there. And also find the sum of 15 terms in each case, sum of first 15 terms in each case, sum of first 15 terms in each case. So we need to find sum of 15 terms we have to find, and also we have to check whether this series of numbers will form an arithmetic progression or not. See here, that is a general term is given, an is equals to 3 plus 4n is given. We don't know the first term, and we don't know the second term, we don't know the third term, and we don't know the common difference, and we don't know whether it is the arithmetic progression or not. So we have to find whether the series of numbers will form an arithmetic progression or not. So what is given here? It is first question, it is an is equals to 3 plus 4n. If n is equals to 1, that is a1, substitute n is equals to 1, that is equals to 3 plus 4 into n is equals to 1, simplify, 3 plus 4 into 1 is equals to 4, that is 3 plus 4 is 7, the first term it is 7. Similarly, n is equals to 2, that is a2, a2 means n is equals to 2, that is equals to 3 plus 4 into 2, that is equals to 3, plus 4 into 2 it is 8, 3 plus 8 is equals to 11. Then a3 is equals to what it is? N is equals to 3, that is 3 plus 4 into 3. 4 into 3 it is 12, 3 plus 12, that is equals to 15. Then an is equals to, it is given, 3 plus 4n. We need to prove that. Then next A4 will become what it is. A4 is equals to 3 plus 4 into 4, that is 3 plus 16, we get 19. Now check whether this A1, A2 and A3 are in the arithmetic progression or not. If you observe, A1 is equal to 7, A2 is 11, A3 is 15. The difference of A2 minus A1, A2 minus A1, that is equals to 11 minus 7, which is equals to 4. A3 minus A2, that is equals to 15 minus 11, is equals to 4. Now, the difference is same. Hence, we can say, therefore, 7, 11, 15, and so on, form an AP that is CD. Common difference is 4. The common difference is 4. Now, first part of the formula is over. That we have proved that it is the arithmetic progression. Next, we need to find the also finding sum of 15 terms. Sum of 15 terms. Now, S n is equal to what? N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Here n is equal to what? 15. First 15 terms. Therefore, it is S 15 is equal to n is equal to 15. 15 by 2 into 2a, 2 into a means this first term is equal to how much we got? 7, so into 7 plus n minus 1, n is equal to 15, 15 minus 1 into d is equal to what? Common difference, how much it is? 4, common difference is how much it is? 4, you can write here, therefore d is equal to 4, common difference is equal to how much it is? 4, substitute d is equal to 4 and simplify. That is 15 by 2 into 2 into 7 into 7 is 14 plus 15 minus 1 is equal to 14 into 4. That is equal to 15 by 2 into 14 plus 14 into 4. 14 4 is 56. That is equal to 15 by 2 into 14 plus 56 is equal to 70. Now simplify. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10. 35 will get. That is equal to what? That is equal to 15 into 35. 15 into 35. Multiply with 15. 15 divided. 15 5s are 75. 5. 15 3s are 45. 45 plus 7 is 32. Will get 525. Therefore, S 15 is equal to 525. Like this, you find the sum of first n terms. So in this, two parts are there. First part, we have to check whether this series of numbers is in the arithmetic progression or not. If it is in arithmetic progression, then find sum of first 15 terms. So we need to check it. And the term is given, an is equal to 3 plus 4n. We don't know whether it is in arithmetic progression or not. Now you take n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, then you substitute in the place of n, that is a1 is equal to 3 plus 4 into 1, that is 3 plus 4 into 1 is equal to 4, 3 plus 4 is 7. Similarly, a2 will get 11 and a3 will get 15 and so on. Now check whether these three numbers are in the arithmetic progression or not by finding the different, that is consecutive terms. a2 minus a1 is equal to 4. A3 minus A2 is equal to 4. We got the same difference. Therefore, this number, that is 7, 15, 11 and 15 are in the arithmetic progression with the first term as 7 and common difference is 4. Now we know, first term we know, common difference we know, n we know. We need to find sum of first 15 terms by using the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Substitute the values. Then simplify, we'll get S 15 is equal to 525. 525. Like this, we will solve this sum. Is it clear, children? Now, if we come to the homework part, textbook, page number 113. Exercise number 5.3, question number 6, question number 7, question number 10, second page, and question number 11. You can solve these 4 sums using the knowledge which you have shared already. So complete this homework. I think you understand today's sums. I hope you understand, and thank you very much.